Good afternoon. Welcome to our third part of our Women's Spring Wellness. My name is Susan Johnson. I am from the East Coast of the United States. I live in Rhode Island, and this particular topic is one that I really love. I absolutely love talking about cleanses. I like talking about supporting the body, and I love talking about a healthy microbiome. So this is real fun for me. So I want to kind of start by kind of recapping a lot of what everyone else said. First of all, why should you cleanse? Cleansing is important to the body. In today's world, we are so bombarded with toxicity, things that our ancestors never saw, right? So we not only have, you know, the toxicity from chemicals, right? Let's talk about our chemical cleaners, our beauty products, what's in our air. We have the electromagnetic frequencies or fields. We get them from Bluetooth, we get them from Wi-Fi. Everybody's on their phone. And there's a lot of research today that talks about those electromagnetic frequencies and how they're actually bothering the interstitial fluid. That's the fluid that's within your cells. So we need to be careful about that. We want to talk about our stress. Stress is a huge toxicity on the body. All the emotions are stored in the liver, and that bear or that stress is on us all the time. Back when we were in the caveman days, we would face the bear, the cortisol would come in, we'd run back to the cave and we'd relax for 3 days and we'd have that ability to kind of let the body relax and detox. We no longer get that today. It's the kids, it's the husband, it's the job, it's the money, it's the politics, it's everything that's out there. There's just so much coming at us. So there's a lot of toxicity, emotional relationships and those kind of things. And then we can talk about the toxicity from our foods. When you look at today's food supply, it is so different than 75 years ago. You know, genetically modified foods, and I talk a lot about this, are a huge, huge, huge factor in the toxicity that goes on today. And if you read my little Did You Know post, and I'll talk about that in a minute, this is some of the reasons that you need to work on detoxifying. So they genetically modify crops to accept the chemical of Roundup. That's one of the chemicals is glyphosate. And that is because glyphosate is a huge killer, right? It's a weed killer. It was actually patented as an antibiotic, and it does kill bacteria, it kills plants, it really kills anything that it's sprayed on. Well, they genetically modified the plants to be able to accept it so that the plants could grow and be sprayed with Roundup so that they wouldn't have to worry about pesticides and that for the crop. But there's another place that we get glyphosate, and they now use glyphosate to actually kill crops like wheat, like rice, like barley. They actually spray it on the crops so the crops all die at once. So they use it as a killer. The plants might not have been genetically modified, but they're using it to kill. And why is this so important? Well, glyphosate is very, very interesting. It's very toxic to the body. It can do a lot of different things. So glyphosate, because it was is patented as an antibiotic, it can actually kill the microbiome in your system. And our microbiome, and we are about 3% our genetic makeup, and about 97% of us comes from everything that's in our microbiome. These are the bacterias, the bugs, the viruses, the worms, everything that lives within our system. And we live mostly symbiotically with them. They help us breathe. They help us think. Our microbiome actually creates the serotonin in our body that helps us overcome things like anxiety and depression. And it's why we keeping a very good, strong, healthy microbiome is so important. Well, glyphosate, because it's an antibacterial, can kill the bacteria in your body. But there's a second thing that glyphosate does, and I'll bring this all into cleansing in a minute, is that it can actually bind the minerals. It binds minerals in the soil and it binds minerals in your body. And what does this mean? When it binds minerals like zinc, selenium, manganese, these are all things that your body needs to naturally work. It binds them and makes them unavailable. They're no longer bioavailable to the body. And you actually have to throw more minerals at yourself than you normally would to compensate for the fact that we're eating products that have been sprayed with glyphosate. So you're always in a negative because you just can't get enough if you're eating genetically modified foods. So cleansing from things like genetically modified foods are really important. And then the other place in foods that we really have to be mindful of are things like our oils, things like sunflower oil, safflower oil, canola oil, soybean oil. Those are all omega-6s, and we get way too many of them, and they cause an inflammatory response. So we often need to detoxify from the foods that we eat. And then there's emotional cleanses. So we have a lot of this that goes on. So why should you cleanse? because all these different places are coming at us. And it's kind of like placing straws on a camel's back. And everybody's body's different. You know, you say, well, you know, my grandfather's 95 and he smoked cigarettes and ate all these things and it's never bothered him. That's because his system didn't have as many straws on the back. Some of us are just naturally born with more because we get things from our parents or we've been exposed to more. So we naturally have more straws on the back and it breaks that camel faster. So where I might not break until I'm 45, someone else might break at their 20, someone else might not break until they're 85 and ready to go on to the next part of life. It all depends. And you have to look at your body individually and find out where you are. For me, my body was a crash at 45 and 46. I was a total mess and had to change my whole lifestyle so that now as I go to turn 57, I'm in a way better place and have done a lot of these different things. So types of cleanses. We know that Tricia talked about all the different types of cleanses that there are out there. You need to look at your body and determine where your body is and what you need and where to go. But just like both Laura and Tricia said, it's very important that you start from the very beginning. You start with your environment and then you start with your body. You start with, you know, changing your diet, changing your foods. And then you look at your colon and I'll talk a little bit about that in a moment as well. Now, who should cleanse? This is really important. So people who should never cleanse are going to be moms that are pregnant. Women who are pregnant should never cleanse. The actual umbilical cord or the pathway to the baby is actually a pathway of elimination. So a woman who is pregnant should never, never, never detox. And this is why they often can't tell you, bottles will say, you know, women who are pregnant shouldn't use this because you can never test a product on a pregnant woman because of that connection with the baby. Another person that would need to be very mindful about cleansing would be someone who is highly compromised. You're someone who is really suffering from many different things. Some of the cleanses that we've talked about would be way too much for your body. We're doing more natural things like just changing your diet in small ways would be the way to start. Because you can throw yourself into something called a Herxheimer reaction. And a Herxheimer reaction is when you have a bad physical response to a change or a cleanse or a detox that you've done. And this can come in the way of hives, like Laura talked about, headaches. It can come with stomach upset. But when you talk about heavy metal detoxification, there are actually reports of people becoming paralyzed because they tried to detox from very heavy metals like mercury and lead in that and didn't do it properly. The body wasn't prepared. So those people who are really at the far end of the spectrum and very sick need to be very mindful about cleansing. And those of us that sit in the middle, we need to figure out what we want to do. We want to talk to our healthcare provider, and we want to make sure that we are at the right place. So when should you cleanse? Tricia Kahn, you know, really went through all this, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this. But, you know, there are different times. The one area I will talk about is that if you are looking to adjust your microbiome, and your microbiome is everything from, again, bacteria, viruses, worms. It's everything that's inside your body that helps you function. The best time to work with this type of cleanse is at the new moon. You would start products that help support the detoxification system at the new moon. You would take them for 21 days, and then you would take 7 days off. You can also start at the full moon. We often, when we do them ourselves, we do new moon, 21 days, 7 days off, new moon, 21 days, 7 days off. And then we wait till the full moon and do one at the full moon and then 7 days off. And people say, well, why would you do that? Well, many of the microbiome in our system actually run, they work on the fact that they're there to survive. And when we go in and we give the body things that are going to support its ability to get rid of those things, they're going to do everything they can to survive, so they often plant the next generation. And by doing these repeated cleansings of the body, we really starve those microbiome that are really bad, and they don't have the ability to keep going. So that's why you would work with those kind of things, particularly, again, that microbiome, working with all that, definitely working with the moon cycles. I'll also tell you this, and I don't know if I didn't hear if Tricia mentioned this or not, but never cleanse during Christmas, your birthday, or a vacation, because you will find that it will just frustrate you. When you're doing a cleanse, obviously you're eating more healthy. There might be some restrictions on what you do. it's just a frustrating time to do it. And you'll waste a lot of money because most people, when they go on vacation, can't maintain it, or the birthdays, because there's things like cakes and all that kind of stuff. And remember, when you're working with cleansing, throwing those sugars on your body is like adding fuel to the fire. Whether you're working with your microbiome, or you're working with trying to de-stress, detoxify inflammation or brain fog. So always thinking about when you're doing that's really important. But again, those holiday seasons are really big. Just know this, that when you do pick it, there will be something that will come up. So carefully plan around that so you can be ready if your husband's birthday is at that time, so you have something else that you can do. Another people ask, how often? Well, this depends on what you're looking to do. It's always good to work with your body healthfully. I have a lot of people I work with, they're like gluten-free or plant paradox or something like that. They'll often do, you know, 5 days of healthy eating, and then on the weekends they'll let themselves go, and they'll do 5 days of healthy eating and they'll let themselves go. But when you talk about something more like a microbiome cleanse, twice a year, maybe once a year, and again, it just depends on the type of cleanse that you're doing. There are other types of cleanses, things like colon cleanses that you could do once a quarter. And then there are those that you could actually do once a month just to kind of prepare your body. There are some fasting cleanses and things like that. So really researching your cleanse and finding out what the best protocol is the best way to go. And remember, you can always go to your healthcare professional to find out what might be best for your body. So let's really get into my subject. So this is preparing the body. And everyone's kind of talked a little bit about this, but let's really dive into the deep of it. So the first thing that you need to know is that before you start any cleanse, you need to make sure that all pathways of elimination are open. And what are your pathways of elimination? So they would obviously be your colon. You need to be going to the bathroom regularly. We'd like to see 3 times a day, but 2 times a day at least. 1 if it's a really good one and you're feeling really good. And the reason that this is when anytime you detoxify, so even if you just turn out and eat clean, when you start to detoxify, the body is an amazing detoxification system. And if we didn't have all this stuff coming at us, we wouldn't need to really necessarily do so many cleanses. But because we have so much coming at us, we need to actually physically work those cleanses. And when we start to do that, the body starts releasing things. When you have toxicity in the body, so let's say that you work in a city, you're breathing a lot of city air and all that kind of stuff. When the body gets backed up and it has toxicity and the liver can't work through it, it can't pass it out, you can't leave it, the body will actually recycle that toxicity. And in order to save the body, it actually covers it in fat and it tucks it throughout your body in different organs. So when you go to lose weight or you start to eat better, that those fat molecules will start to break up and the toxicity is released into the body. When we work with a microbiome cleanse and we start adjusting that microbiome, maybe having some die off of some bad and planting some good, particularly when you put good probiotics down there and it kills off the bad stuff that's down there, that releases toxins. And if you are backed up, if you're not going to the bathroom, it will totally back up the system. And again, it can come out through your skin. It could cause headaches, it cause brain fog, or again, it can recycle through your body and actually plant itself in other places and actually be more toxic than it was before. So you need to be able to go into the bathroom regularly. You want to make sure you're doing good deep breathing exercises. You want to make sure that maybe you're dry brushing your skin to keep your skin, that's another pathway of elimination, open. Drinking lots of water, urination is another pathway of elimination. And then for those of you who might still have a cycle, a menstrual cycle is another pathway of elimination. So, you know, that's another place that, you know, if you are going regular, that's great. For those of us that no longer have that cycle, we have to be even more mindful to make sure that other pathways of elimination are open. So one other thing that can happen if your pathways of elimination are not open, or if you do a cleanse, is you can often get a hormonal imbalance. When we make changes to the body quickly, particularly if you haven't prepared well, you can have a little hormonal imbalance come on. You can get really emotional. You know, sometimes people get weepy and they cry. It's a great way to release cortisol and other things, but they don't understand why they feel that way. You can also kind of get, you know, aggressive. So understand that sometimes when you cleanse, especially if you haven't done a good preparation, you might feel those kind of things. So once we know that we need to open those pathways of elimination. How do we do that? First and foremost, your food. Food is amazing. And food, you are what you eat. It can also, as you've heard, be a bad toxification center for your body. So you want to make sure you're eating organic. You want to make sure that you're drinking purified water. You want to do grass-fed meats. And truthfully, if you're going into a cleanse, you want to make sure that you're not overloading the body with a lot of heavy proteins. That doesn't mean you go vegan or anything like that. It really, it's up to the cleanse. But know that the more heavy of the foods that you eat, like proteins, the more the body can struggle with the processing of it. So we want to try to do lighter things when we're detoxifying so that the body can work with it. You also want to make sure that you're leaving a good window of opportunity for detoxification. So it takes about 6 hours for the body to actually digest food. You'd want to give it another 2. So it takes about 8 hours for the body to run through a detoxification system. And as Tricia mentioned, intermittent fasting actually has you go push to 12 or 16. It just allows that body time to go through the entire detoxification cycle. If you are eating at 9 o'clock at night or 10 o'clock at night in front of the TV, and then you're getting up at, 5 o'clock in the morning, you're not giving that body really enough time. You really want to make sure you're pushing it past that 8 hour window so it has that opportunity to fully detox. So exercise is another great way, but you want to be careful of exercise during a cleanse. Good walking is healthy. Some cleanses are very taxing on the body and you wouldn't want to over-exercise. It can just cause more exertion. Geek out. I love it. So let's talk about products. So the first things that you want to use, let's say it's me and I want to start a healthy detoxification. I've started with my food. So I'm eating clean food. I'm drinking clean water. I'm going to want to use lemon in my water. I love lemon, 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 lemon. Look up D-limonene, look up the properties of lemon. It is amazing. Putting this in your water is such a good support to the entire system. Particularly when you look at healthy kidney function and healthy lymph function, this is amazing. So we always, when we do, we call it a lighten your liver load, where we try to bring that toxicity down so that the liver can work better. We always work with lemon. I personally use Vitality Lemon in my water. I start the first month usually about 5 drops, and I'll go up to about 15 drops in a glass, throughout the day in a glass of water. I think it's really wonderful for the system, and you often hear about people using lemon every morning. The next thing, amazing for any kind of a person who wants to prepare their body, is Essential Zyme 4. If you've never tried this, this is an amazing product. It's a blister pack. It comes with 2 capsules, one breaks down carbs and sugars, and one breaks down fat and proteins. You want to make sure that you are digesting really well when you're in a cleanse. So this is a fabulous, fabulous product to use. The next one would be the probiotic using a Life 9. If you are really working on attacking the bad microbiome in your body, you wouldn't necessarily take a probiotic while you're doing that. And those things that would really help you attack the bad microbiome in your body would be things like Parafree. Love Parafree. Really helps support a healthy microbiome. Parafree is one of those ones that I would work with that moon cycle, 21 days on, 7 days off. And this one, I think you do either 2 or 3 times, 3 soft gels, 2 times a day for best results, take for 21 days, 7 days off and replete for 3 cycles. So they're 3 cycles as well. When I did my last one, I actually combined this one, which is really great for microbiome support, with Mimosa Pudica. This is not a Young Living product, but these two together are excellent to work together. And that's when, again, coming back from Guatemala and India, I had that huge cleanse and actually passed 10-inch worms, a whole nest of them. So not to gross anybody out, but it's an amazing feeling. And I felt really good after I'd done it. And I thought, where were they hiding? I'm not an overly big person. And I thought, man, where were they in my body? Some of the other things that you would use to support the body and cleansing with Young Living would be lemongrass and Digize together. They are really excellent for the microbiome. Using the Vitality, putting them in the capsule and using them would be great. Look at the bottle for the actual amount that you would want to use. And I know that in the next segment that Melissa's going to talk about the cleansing trio, and she's going to talk about the 5-day nutritive cleanse. These are two really wonderful, wonderful products or group of products that you can use to support your body and help the body naturally work through eliminating toxins. Other products would be Comfort Tone, ICP, they're part of those. Peppermint is always wonderful. If you're going to look to detox specific organs, those that you can use to support those organs while you do it, Rehemagen, this is a product most people don't know about. It is a tincture. It helps support healthy cellular function, healthy digestion. K&B, mineral essence, lemon and frankincense are all great to support the kidney if you're looking to work with the kidney. And then the ICP, Comfort Tone, peppermint all help work with the colon. So starting with, let me see a question. I can begin with Essentialzyme. Yep, Essentialzyme 4. Here's my thing about Essentialzyme 4. If you are not on Essentialzyme 4 every day of your life, you need to be. If you stranded me on a desert island and you said that there were a couple of things that you needed, Essentialzyme 4 would be one of the products I would take. If they gave me the standard American diet or the diet, even the diet I eat clean, you said you need one product, I'd tell you this. You take it with each big meal. It will make such a difference in your life. And if you struggle with things like that regularity, working with getting better digestion, Essentialzyme 4 will really help you poop better. I mean, you definitely want to make sure that you're pooping well, and working with an Essentialzyme 4, working with a probiotic, all those things help support healthy digestion, how you chew your food, the type of food. But these are things that are amazing. You can start these right away. And even if you're not cleansing, you should be doing them all the time. I mean, I just love this product. I think it's absolutely amazing. So you are going to use lemon in your water. You're going to use your Essentialzyme. I would put Digize on my belly. The package lasts how long? So this package is 60 dual capsules. It's a 30-day supply. Most people take them with their two biggest meals. I might not, if I've really had a light meal, like I've only done a smoothie for lunch and I'm doing dinner, I might not take the second pack, but it's a 30-day supply. So it's really good. So let's see. Oh, thank you. You're welcome. Let's see. There's another one. If you hold the pocket reference from Young Living, if you hold the pocket reference guide from Life Science Publishing, Gary actually created something called Quad Shield. Quad Shield is a protocol that you can do to help your body maintain a healthy protection against electromagnetic frequency. Quad Shield has Super C chewables, it has thiamine, it has longevity. It was the capsules at a time, but you can use the essential oil. And there's a fourth one. I can't remember what the fourth product is in Quad Shield, but it's really good when you fly. Melrose, you're right. Thank you. Yes, Melrose. When you fly, it's really amazing. And it's something, again, if you live in a place where you're exposed to a lot of electromagnetic frequency, you want to support your body as much as you can, it would be a great thing to use. So that would be the other one. Let me say a couple of things here. So your big takeaway is that enzymes are the master workers in your body. These guys break down all of the food that you eat. Remember, proteins, fats, carbs, sugars. And that there are three products that I think are really good to support your body while cleansing are going to be Digize, lemon, and Essentialzyme 4. So those three products are amazing. Big takeaways for you guys. I'm going to kind of finish up here and then we can kind of come off the recording and take some questions and answers. Opening up your pathways of elimination is absolutely important. You need to make sure that you're eating the right food, you're drinking the right water, you're going to the bathroom, that you that every elimination pathway is open. And then you want to make sure that you have taken a good look at what your goal is. If your goal is a parasite cleanse, you're looking to really balance out that microbiome in your body, you can't just do a parasite cleanse. You need to do everything else up until that time and then support it. So clean out your house, clean out your eating, support your pathways of elimination, do a colon cleanse, a kidney cleanse, and then work for something more hefty on your microbiome. Does that mean you can't start with using a good probiotic now? Absolutely not. There are many things that we can do to support a healthy microbiome before we actually cleanse. When you take a good probiotic, it actually goes in and kills out, weeds out some of the bad stuff and starts to plant good. It makes that final cleanse that you do, that really big, strong one that where you're really supporting the ability to get rid of the bad stuff, it makes it that much easier. So always know what your goal is and what steps you need to do before you get there. And always make sure that if you have any kind of a compromise system, you check with your doctor before you do it. And then, you know, again, look at what kind of cleanse you're doing. So parasite cleanses for me, you know, really working with balancing out my microbiome. I do that probably 3 times a year. I travel a lot. I go to a lot of foreign countries. And for me, that's really important because we're eating foods that we might not normally eat. For the average Joe back in the day, they did it with the change of the season. They did a spring one. They did a fall one. On the farms, I grew up in a farm country. We had a lot of farms here. They did the worming. They dewormed the cows. They dewormed the kids. You did it twice a year. It was just part of the equation. So really looking into it. And the books that both Tricia and Laura talked about, the Ultimate Transformation book, those are amazing books. They are great, great resources, as well as your books from Life Science Publishing. The big desk reference guide is amazing and has a lot of information on using these products to support whatever detoxification you're looking to do. All right. Well, thanks for listening. Let me come off of this and stop the recording, and we will take